السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus, the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri Rahmatullahi Alayh. Lesson number 783. This is a very emotional lesson filled with love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, it was the 12th of Rabi'ul Awal, the 7th of June. After Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, the first salah was the salah of Dhuhr. Bilal radiallahu ta'ala an came to give the adhan. And remember, this is just giving us the lesson of the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Historic books have written that when Bilal radiallahu ta'ala an came to the word Ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah in the adhan, then Bilal radiallahu an started crying. And he was unable to complete the adhan. One of the other Sahabi came and they completed the adhan. And then Bilal radiallahu anhu took a qasam and he said, for my entire life I'm not going to give the adhan. How do I relive those memories whereby Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam would exit his blessed living place and come out of there when I should say Ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah? So then after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was buried, then Bilal radiallahu anhu came to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And he says, oh Abu Bakr, I find it very difficult for me to live in Medina Munawwara. In the areas of Sham, there is a group of Sahaba that are fighting and striving in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Send me there. I will go there and I will be part of that group. Bilal radiallahu ta'ala an left towards the area of Sham. 100,000 Sahaba were there making effort and striving for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After 6 months, Bilal radiallahu ta'ala an, he sees a dream. No other Sahabi sees a dream. Nabi alayhi salam comes into the dream of Bilal radiallahu an and he says, Bilal, what is this estrangement from you? You have left us and you haven't visited us again. Bilal radiallahu ta'ala an, when he wakes up, then immediately he gets ready and he comes to Medina Munawwara. And as he comes to the border of Medina Munawwara, the excitement, the jubilation that is there, he comes and he says, Ya Rasulullah, your slave Bilal has come. Your slave Bilal has come. The aspect of the Nabi of Allah leaving this world has totally left the mind of Bilal. He is thinking that my Nabi is alive. And as he comes closer and closer to the Hujra Mubarak, to the place where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was buried, and then he realizes, and he understands the reality. He's saying, Bilal has come, Bilal has come. But alas, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was no more. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has left this temporary world. He came to the Mubarak Qabr of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he held the Qabr, and he fell on the Qabr. And then all the Sahaba looked, and then they remembered Bilal. Now who has the courage to tell Bilal that you should give the adhan? Who has the courage to tell Bilal that you must go and give the adhan? They go to Hassan and Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhumah. 6-7 years of age they were. And then they say, oh Hassan and Hussein, you go and you tell Bilal he must give the adhan. They come to him, they say, Chachazan, oh our uncle, we have one request. Bilal radiallahu anhu says, what request? Give me the order. I will sacrifice my life for you. They say, give the adhan of our grandfather. Give the adhan of our grandfather. Bilal radiallahu anhu says, but I took a qasam, I won't give adhan. But for your sake, I will break the qasam. I will give the kafara. But because of you, I will give the adhan. Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu went to one of the houses of the area, one of the Ansari houses. And he stood on that house. And then Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in his spiritual voice, he says, Allahu Akbar. All of a sudden in Medina, there was a different atmosphere. People started crying. People started remembering the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina. They remembered when he was alive. They remembered when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was there. The beloved wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr, Umar radiallahu an, everyone in Medina started crying. Everyone in Medina was emotional. They were remembering the glorious days when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to be alive in Medina Munawwara, and Bilal radiallahu an used to call the adhan. At that time, Ma Aisha radiallahu anha, she wrote a letter to Bilal radiallahu an. Perhaps at a later stage, inshallah, we will read the contents of that letter. Friends, this is the true love that Sahaba Ikram radiallahu ta'ala anhu possessed for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us, and may He honor us with that love of that great Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen, ameen, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.